conception is conception. It is intentional. It is political. And we know what we are saying, believe me. Because how can a man who says he's a union leader or a labor leader who attended university can come around and be saying that our advertisement minister attended schools? They said, oh, why did you charge fees for forms? Why not? We are the same form. If you say you want to you want to do exams, why do you pay for forms for exams? Does that mean you pass the exams?
Your views are well taken.
Yeah.
The position of the administration well taken.
Yeah, but they are
being properly communicated to the outside.
Yeah,
that is why we are here.
Thank
now
you
we talk about the economy of Oyo State.
Yes, yes.
You were once quoted as saying that you will take Oyo State out of the economic doldrums.
Yes.
Out of the group.
Yes.
Where are we now?
I think that's a very good question. Start with where is Nigeria now? Can Oyo State exist outside Nigeria? No. When there is a national economic catastrophe, it affects everyone. More so in a federation where there is no true federalism, where the state must go cast in hand to go and beg Abuja for money, and where the economic base, the industrial base, the socio-economic base of Oyo State is not sufficient to launch Oyo State without going into agriculture, without looking inwards. And now we have started looking inwards. Now we have brought in some industries for Oyo State. But even at that, economics is not about one action. It's about multidimensional actions. It's about the people. It's about logistics. It's about the environment. It's about infrastructure. It's about manpower. It's about so many things. Economics is not about government alone. What's government? Who is government? Government is the supervising and coordinating authority of the activities of the people. That's what government is. So the people must, and that's why we say democracy is about people. Everybody must participate. And we are trying to say, education. Those countries that are doing well today, they are countries that have solid background education-wise. They are countries that have been. What is education? Education is structured information. Structured information is education. Education is knowledge. Knowledge is ability. Ability is skills. Skills is capability. Capability is empowerment. Empowerment is self-sufficiency. So what we are saying is, we start from education, basic. If people cannot produce anything, if they don't know how to do anything, they cannot. The economy cannot grow. That's why we are starting from education. And the education we are having now, it cannot stand the test of time. Many of our graduates, students cannot even speak correct English. Even the teachers.
Do you want teachers?
Yes, I'm telling you. I've seen them. We've spoken to them. That was the other day when Governor Shomole in Bende, in Edo State, he was talking to some teachers to read. The woman cannot read. He's a teacher. I've seen teachers here. You say, what happened to you? They beaten me. Teachers. How many men? Nine men. Teachers.
In
Oyo State. Yes. I've spoken to them. But this is not the issue. We want to train. We want to educate. Our education must be a productive one. Must be a contributory one. Not just going to school for the sake of going to school. By the way, it's not only theoretical education. There must be practical. There must be technical colleges. We are doing all this together. We study it. My brother, are you saying that you are happy with the state of our education in Oyo State? If you say yes, then believe me, we will stop. We don't need to do anything.
If I listen to what he says,
that you are happy with the way education is in Oyo State, if you say yes, and the public say yes,
it will be better, sir.
Thank you. So it could be better means It's not where you are.
No, no, no.
Yeah. It's not where you want to be. So what we are saying is, can we change it? But before changing it, can we not be Scottish?
And we are hearing you now.
And you say you don't want to be Scottish.
And they can share your pay.
And then the next thing, you don't talk about education again. You now say, pay our 6 months salaries. Why did they go on strike in the first place? Was it because of salaries? No. They didn't go on strike because of salaries. They said they were fighting education. Now they are not talking about education. They are talking about no more 6 months salary. Am I the only one who's not paying salary? Eh? All states are not paying salaries. All states. Except maybe Lagos State and others. And you know something? All these salary. The federal government gives us, when the federal government was giving us all the money we needed, I was paying salaries before 25th of every month. I increased salaries of workers and teachers 3 times. An average teacher that was earning 52,000 naira, go and ask them how much they are earning now, 167,000. They are not telling the public that. I was paying every year, they work for 1 year, 12 months. I will give them 13 months. They are not telling the public that. I did that for 3 years. No governor has ever done it. These same people were singing praises of me. I did not give the best. I increased their salary. I provided buses for workers. I was giving them training. I was doing everything for them. They were, even this labor, I bought them buses. I helped them to do their schools. I did many things. And they would say, I did not give number one. Now that you don't have money, they say 6 months. I believe you. 100% of the salary of the allocation we get from federal government, we give them. We don't use any money to do anything in the state. It's only workers. 100,000 people taking all the money from 7 million people.
We just have 1 2 minutes to go to the state. I appreciate you very much. Another thing that we really talk about is town, double town, is election.
Election?
Yes.
Yeah.
The local
yeah.
They say that you don't want to do one.
Yeah. They said it. And they've always said many things that are not correct. They even said we will never do one. But now we have appointed, we had a court case when we came in. We met it on ground. The previous administration sacked some people from the Chief Ladoja's administration. Fakala sacked some of the OCF members. They went to court. They said they didn't pay them. And they were in court for a long time. We were the one who vacated the case. And as soon as we have vacated, we decided, okay, election was coming, the major election. We did the election. As soon as we finished, we now said, okay, we vacated it. Now we have OCF in place. And OCF has 90 days. To conduct election, before the election is conducted. And I guarantee you will have that election. It is also part of this game, that people saw that local government election is coming. Some of them are now going around and they are saying, let's create civil unrest, let's create animosity between the governor that people love, that defeated us, and let's see. And the beauty of this is that Oyo State people are intelligent people. They can see between the lines. And the more I explain to them, the more they see now. Otherwise, why would people go to town and be lying that we are sold schools when we are not even sold any school, when we don't intend to sell schools? So, election is coming. We are ready for it. And by God's grace, just like we have defeated them before, we will defeat them again. No matter their imagination,
Your Excellency, I would appreciate you. But one thing that is sure, obviously, is that hopefully for the other teams we agree with you. How are we going to ever have the symphony of joy?
I think the symphony of joy will always come when what is a symphony? Symphony is a combination of musicians. Oh, somebody will be playing trumpet, somebody will be playing piano, somebody. It's the fact. very intelligent man. That is what describes democracy. Symphony of ideas.
I was going to say,
you will always think, and you will see, this one is just another storm. It's just another noise. And you know something? You know, there was this restaurant where only rich people, only noble people go there. Men of quality in the society. And decent men go there. And there was this date. One of these hoodlums made a lot of money, became rich. He went to that restaurant. And when people were eating, you know, in that restaurant, you don't make noise. Your fork, your spoons, you are trained there to about simple decency and
table manners.
Thank you, that's the memory. And everybody was eating. And when the hoodlum came in with his wife, they started making noise with the forks and the knives. The restaurant people went and asked, excuse me, can you? Then after another 15 minutes, the woman and the man started fighting at him. The woman just slapped the man, the husband. The husband just got up, took a bowl of soup, poured it on the head of that woman. And everybody in the restaurant said, ha, we've never seen this before. So they now asked them to leave the room. As they were going out, everybody just had their mouth open. And the husband came back and said, what's wrong with you? If you don't see people like me once in a while, you won't know that there are bad people in this world. And they left. If we don't see these discordant tunes once in a while, we won't know that there are devils in this
world. That's what it shapes you. For your time. Thank you very much for being that open. And I want to assure you that all that you have said will be communicated to the different pockets in your state. One thing, thank you very much for your excellency, Senator Abiola.
Thank you very much.